Hello friends, today I am going to share with you a research study on a title called A Comparative Study to Assess Aerobic Capacity in Normal Females versus Hypotensive Females. Let us see this topic in detail. Introduction: the global burden of hypertension as a leading risk factors for cardiovascular and kidney disease and for mortality has overshadowed the possible health problem associated with chronic low blood pressure. Because in NCDs we mainly focus on hypertension, diabetes, obesity, etc., we have overcome the effect of hypotension. In most healthy adults, low blood pressure does not cause any problem or symptoms, and there are really very few studies evaluating the fitness in the hypotensive individual. Person's fitness level is dependent on the amount of oxygen which can be transported by the body to the working muscles and the efficiency of the muscle to use that oxygen. VO2 max is internationally accepted parameters to evaluate the cardiorespiratory fitness, and this study aims at evaluating the level of fitness VO2 max values in normal and hypotensive individual through Queen's College step test. Now, materials and methods used for this studies: design of the study, cross-sectional study, sample size 70 females were recruited, hypothesis VO2 max values of normal and hypotensive females are same. Procedure: data is collected by assessing the VO2 max indirectly by Queen's College step test. The subject step up and down on a platform at a rate of 22 steps per minute. The subjects have to use 4 step cadence, like up, up and down, down, for 3 minutes. The subject stops immediately on completion of the test, and the VO2 max values were calculated for both the groups. Data analysis: the test used was the Z-test, level of significance p less than 0.05, and confidence interval was 95%. These are the results. Group 1 denotes the normal individual, group 2 denotes the hypotensive individual. SBP 114.85 plus standard deviation, group 2 101.77, DBP 74.57 in group 1, group 2 62.86. Heart rate at rest for group 1 77.97, for group 2 81.77. Heart rate after the exercise 86.97, for group 2 94.4, and VO2 max 49.42 and 48.05. Now, this particular graph denotes VO2 max values for the normal and hypotensive individual. Here you can see with the green in the other color, VO2 max values for the normal individual is quite high, and VO2 max value for the hypertensive individual is less. The discussion of this study: the finding of the present study suggests the normal individual has a higher VO2 max value than the hypotensive individual. Now, the primary hypotension or the low blood pressure that develop in the absence of any underlying disease or cause. However, the persons with the primary hypertension are not easily susceptible to heart or renal disorder. Frequent fatigue and the weakness are the common complaint of the patient. This could be probable reason that the normal individual has a good capability to work, whereas hypertensive individual get fatigues very soon, thus cannot work for a long time, and thus the VO2 max value is less than the normal individual. And there are studies suggesting the correlation between the hypertension and even anxiety and depression. So what's the conclusion of this study? VO2 max values were found to be higher in normal individual as compared to the hypotensive females. Scope for the future research: it can be done on the large population with the different variables. What's the relevance to the public health and in our clinical practice? Hypertension also needs attention when compared with the other non-communicable disease. We need to take care of the physical fitness of the individuals with the non-symptomatic chronic hypertension. And these were the references which I have taken for the study. So thank you very much for listening. If you are going to do scientific paper presentation, you can refer few of my video where like 10 or 11 slides I have mentioned how you can prepare a PPT that will be like a ready reckoner for you. It will be helpful to you when you are going to prepare the PPT and going to do the presentations. So thank you very much for listening to me. And for further videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, Tarpan Shah, and you can like and share as well.